When we are talking about performance optimizations for Spring Data JPA, the handling of association is always an important topic. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. If you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. Because Spring Data JPA is based on JPA and most often used with Hibernate, you can apply all the performance tuning concept that you can find here on the channel and on my blog. The most important one is to use lazy fetching for all associations and combine it with query-specific fetching. Gazem wants to follow that advice and ask in a comment on a previous article on my blog for the best way to do that. He asks, can you please explain a little more about query-specific fetching? Suppose I'm using Spring Data JPA and Hibernate as my persistence provider. Do I have to use the query annotation to select entities to provide a specific query, or can I use findBy methods provided by the Spring Data JPA repository? Defining your query using Spring Data's query annotation is one option. It allows you to define a custom query, provides great flexibility, and is easy to use. But it's not your only option. You can also add a named entity graph reference to your query method, or implement a custom repository method that uses JPA's Entity Graph API. I have a video about this, which you will find here. In this video, I will show you all three options and explain when you should use them. Spring Data JPA's repositories not only provide you with a set of ready-to-use methods to persist new entity objects or to fetch existing ones via their primary key. You can also provide your own JPQL or native SQA statement, and Spring Data provides the required code to execute it. The only thing you need to do is to add a method to your repository and annotate it with @query. You can then provide your JPQA statement as the value of that annotation. Within that statement, you can use one or more join fetch clauses to specify the associations you want to initialize. In this code snippet, I use this approach to define a query that returns all author entities with their books that have a given first and last name. This is a great approach for all use case specific queries because it combines the query statement with the definition of the required fetching behavior. But sometimes you want to execute the same query in multiple contexts that require different fetching behavior. You then either need to provide a separate repository method and query for each context, or you need to define the fetching behavior programmatically. JPA's named entity graph annotation enables you to create a query-independent graph definition that references the associations you want to initialize. I explain this in great detail in the first part of my guide to JPA's entity graphs. You will find it up here or below in the video description. The following graph tells your persistence provider to fetch the book's attribute of the entity returned by your query. In the next step, you need to combine this graph definition with a query that returns the entities for which you want to initialize the book's attribute. Using plain JPA, this would require some boilerplate code, but thanks to Spring Data JPA, you can do the same by adding the entity graph annotation to your repository method. Using this annotation, you can then reference the graph by its name and define if you want to use it as a fetch or a load graph. Spring Data JPA then derives the query from the method name, instantiates an entity graph with the name graph.author.books, combines the graph with the query, and executes it. Your third option to fetch an association using Spring Data JPA is to use a composite repository. It's by far the most flexible approach, but it also requires the most work. A composite repository enables you to add your own method implementation to a Spring Data JPA repository. Let's give it a try in the IDE. This requires the definition of a fragment interface that defines the method you want to implement and a class that implements the fragment interface. Within the method implementation, you can use the entity manager with all features supported by the JPA specification and your persistence provider, for example, Hibernate. This, of course, would allow you to execute a JPQA query with a join fetch clause or to execute a query with a named entity graph. But as I showed you before, Spring Data JPA's integration are much easier to use. A composite repository is only required if you want to use JPA's Entity Graph API to define your graph at runtime. This can be useful if your graph definition depends on user input. As you have seen, annotating your repository method with @query and providing a JPQA statement with one or more join fetch clauses is by far the easiest approach to initialize an association. As long as there are no other requirements, this is my preferred approach. If you are using plain JPA, named entity graphs are useful to execute the same query with different fetching behaviors. But because Spring Data JPA makes it so easy to add custom queries to a repository, I usually prefer them over entity graphs. The composite repository requires much more code than the two previously discussed options. That's why I only recommend using it if your implementation benefits from the additional flexibility. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about JPA, Hibernate, and Spring Data. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!